Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, welcome. My name is Lindy. I'm an independent hairstylist and I have a passion for all things hair, career, entrepreneurship, and I share a little bit about each one of those things on my channel along with a little bit of life because who doesn't want to get to know people more at a deeper level? And that's my goal, is that through this channel and through my hair Instagram, that I create a relationship with you guys where there's trust built, that you are confident in the information that I provide for you, and that you know that I'm constantly educating myself and really just loving what I get to do here on this platform and the other social platforms that I have. So again, if you are new to my channel, welcome. I hope that you stay around. Today I am going to begin my part two on a two-part series. If you haven't seen part one, I'll link it up here. I'm creating a two-part series on what I wish I would have known and done when I first began as a booth renter, because if you don't know, if you're new here, I am a hairstylist and I rent a booth. I love the independent side of booth rental. I love this independent side of just being my own business and creating my own success. And so through the 5 years that I've been doing this, I have learned a lot, and hopefully it can be beneficial to you as you begin pursuing your dreams as well. But as usual, before we get started, it would mean the world to me that if you like this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you want to stay around and see more of these videos, make sure that you subscribe below. Okay, let's get started. So the first thing that I really wish I would have done from the very start of my hair career as a booth renter is build a social media platform. This one really means a lot to me because I saw the effects that it had on my business and my ability to build faster when I moved from a big city where I began my hair career to a small town where I currently am. When I moved here, I didn't have much of a platform at all in social media, and so I had to build from scratch. As I build a clientele, I realize how important it is for people to be able to see the work that I can do and be able to trust me before actually coming in to see me. And so if I would have had a platform of social media to build off of, I would have had more pictures to show people of the work that I can do. The hair industry is always changing, and so it's really important to stay up on the new trends and the new techniques, and people being able to see that you're able to accomplish those new techniques is super important. The other side of building a social platform is building that relationship aspect with your followers. I know that when I go to see a hairstylist, I want to know that I've seen what they can do, but I also want to know that I can click with them. And I'm huge on interviewing your hairstylist, and as a stylist, interviewing your client, and being okay with walking separate ways if you just don't mesh. There needs to be that connection there. If you can eliminate that by really getting to know each other through social media, that's a huge bonus to you and your business. Building a social media doesn't happen overnight, and the skill that it takes to make it successful and to learn how to brand yourself takes a lot of time. So if you are just starting out, say, you know what, I don't have to be perfect the first time around, but if I start now, I'm gonna learn as I go, and it's gonna benefit my business much quicker than starting 5 years down the road and then trying to learn all the things about social media. The second thing I wish I would have done is spend more time working on my business. So what does that mean? Building a website and budgeting for the future and strategizing for your platforms that are online. And it's learning how to price your services and why you price your services the way that you do, and getting continued education. These are all ways that you are working on your business, and it's necessary to be able to grow and excel at what you do. Clients really appreciate when they can see the effort that you put into your business, and knowing that you really are thinking about what's going to benefit them the most in the future. They can see those things, and they also see the effort that you put into reaching out to them and building that connection, and also educating them in ways that are outside of the salon. You know, I've said this before and I'll say it again, you are the creator of your own success when you're independent as a stylist or whatever it is that you do. If you're not working on ways to better your business, chances are high that you probably won't excel like you really would be able to if you put the time and effort into that. The third thing that I really wish I would have done is spend more time on continued education. I never really even watched YouTube on how to excel at the skill of hair. You know, I hate to look back and regret things because everything happens the way it does to push you further and teach you lessons. But at the same time, I would say, if anything, I'm probably more regretful about that because I do feel like my skill could have advanced much quicker. Making the effort to get on and follow people who are doing what you are doing and have been doing it for much longer and listening to how to excel at your skill. Especially in the beauty industry, the techniques and the trends, they're always changing. So, you know, what you learn in school is very small compared to all the things that you learn in the salon, let alone learn as you're listening to people who are experts in the field. Put the extra effort and time into educating yourself so that you can give your clients your very, very best. If I'm continuing my education, my prices can and will go up eventually. My worth will be way higher because my skill will be better because I have taken the time and I've spent the money to advance my skill. So investing in continued education will be a much bigger blessing than it will a burden in the end. I really encourage you, if you are really in anything you're doing, and especially if you're in the hair industry, start now educating yourself beyond just what you learned in school. Build off a foundation and your skill, your ability to perform a service well, your ability to speak with your clients, and your ability to be on social platforms will all excel. The fourth thing that I really wish I would have done is charged my worth. So there's a lot of things that you need to put into the equation when you go to charge for a service. I'm not going to go into the details of that at this point, but I know that when I first started my career, I was so scared to charge my clients. Even if it was like $60 for a root touch-up or something, I still felt so awkward being like, it's $60. You know, it's like that awkward, like, what reaction are you gonna get? And it can be really tempting to be like, oh, I don't wanna charge them too much. It just sounds like too much, so I'm not going to. But you have to just be confident in what you're worth and the education that you've done and your willingness to take the time to perfect their hair, the product that was used that was bought by you. As booth renters, we buy all of our supplies, and so if we're not even charging for the cost of that product, we're losing money. If we get into a habit of charging emotionally as well and being scared of what people are gonna say and think, it's really going to cost us in the long run because people will get used to those prices, and those are emotional prices. Those aren't actually what the cost of the service was worth. But people will get used to it, and it will really get complicated down the road. So if you start from the very beginning, learn how to properly charge your services, and being confident in the hair that you just created is going to really benefit you down the road with your business if you just start from the very beginning. The fifth thing that I really wish I would have done is kept track of all my expenses and my income. This is definitely an area that I winged from the very beginning. I was just like, okay, I made this much today. Okay, I'm gonna go buy some product that I need. Okay, I have to pay my taxes. I didn't really keep track of anything. I just kind of kept letting money go in and out. So if you can keep track of that, it'll help you better spend money on product, making sure that you're not buying product that you don't need and that's just gonna sit in your cupboard and not be used. It's gonna help you keep track of things that you know have to come out monthly. So rent, taxes, putting money away for taxes, keeping track of those numbers is going to really benefit you in spending your money wisely and making the most with your money. This leads me kind of into my next point. Number six is set goals. I never set goals when I first began. I wasn't really taking my career seriously. I didn't take it seriously that I was a business owner. The other side of it was I didn't really have a good view of like what my passion was and where I wanted to go with my career as a hairstylist. Now that I have established that, it is 100% mandatory that I set goals with those passions and those dreams in mind. What we set our mind on is where we're going to start heading. Our minds play a powerful role, and so getting something on paper and reviewing it and going back and referring to it is going to enable us to take the actions to get there. Number seven, the last one that I have for you guys today is I really wish that I would have had more confidence in myself. That's part of why I didn't really build a social platform, because I didn't feel like I had enough good pictures and work on me to put it out there and say, like, this is what I can do and this is why you can trust me. But you build that trust over time as people see how you improve in your skills. I really allowed the slowness of the growth of my clientele to make me feel like I wasn't doing something right. But I think that we can all agree that experience makes us better, failing makes us better. I really wish I would have just nipped those thoughts right in the butt and said, no, this is not true. I'm going to have the confidence, no matter what, where I am right now, to say I'm gonna put myself out there, because the more clients, I thought I had a spider on my leg. That was creepy. The more clients that I get in my chair, the better I'm gonna get, and that's gonna give me the ability to produce more pictures that are better quality. No picture is going to be 100% perfect. I don't let that get in my way. I just say, you know what? I'm going to be proud of what I can do right now. I'm gonna post it, and I'm going to let the people who are attracted to it come to me. I keep going back to this, and I'll just wrap things up with this one, is that failure really truly breeds success, and I know that and I trust that. And so even as I continue in my career right now as an independent booth renter, I am pursuing each and every one of these things still and trying to improve in those areas. So that is it for today's video. I really hope that it was inspiring or encouraging in some way or another. So if you have any feedback, please leave it in the comments below. I'd love to hear what you'd like to see on my channel, and I am always, always looking forward to creating more videos for you guys. I will see you on the next one. Bye.